Here are the things you can piss me off the most. If you say, if you want to have me on your bedside, say that I have to do something because it is law. Saying that I cannot do something because I am on private ownership from somebody. I have probably done far worse for the environment than me. And how get this because of his bloodline. Some rich elitist kid, most likely, or old fuck. I don't care about the earth. I see, being honest. Did you know that Holocaust was also legal? There was no law against Holocaust of Jews and gypsies and people with mental disabilities. Slavery was law. Apartheid was law. Law is a symbol of might make rights. Don't use it in an argument with me. There are many horrible things that are being law. Slave masters were protected from taking responsibility for their own actions. When the Constitution in America was first acknowledged, only white, slave-owning, European rich men were protected under the law and considered persons. And in many other places of the world, you have the same kind of delusional mindset. If you look to the Findlayist mindset in the West, in the Middle Age, only rich, elite people were considered true persons of society. In old Greek lands, in Athens, the place where first democracy existed, only something like 10 to 20% of the population can vote. They were mostly rich people and people in the military and or served military. The average dude on the street cannot vote in Athens in that time. There are also were laws against women before the half of the turn of the 20th century, I mean, when women get the rights. So don't be ridiculous, people. Stop using this appeal to the status quo, or appeal to social contract, or appeal to being considered humane, which is a sarcasm, because if you are not vegan, you are not humane, and therefore you are not a human, you are just an hominid naked ape to me. And you have no more viral or more right to call some place or a piece of ground your property than a squirrel have, than one turkey have. This planet belongs to all animals on the planet. It does not belong to a delusional naked ape with a god complex. How thinks he have the right to decide which life and which walk on which places? Just because he is born in a wealthy family. Because he is born in the most entitled and most privileged of all species. The two-legged naked ape, how calls himself ironically, humans. Before the 19th century, the word human and humane were interchangeable, used in terms. People called themselves humans because they claimed to be humane. What is sarcastic, because dominating each other and turning each other into slaves and exploiting each other and using laws to manipulate others and turn other living beings into burgers. It's not humane behavior. Humane true color is to be merciful, is being with kindness, is understanding right from wrong. But when have the majority ever stand on the right side of justice from the begin point? The majority always walk after their elitist self-righteous dudes with a lot of money, like, or a lot of political power, or a lot of speech of discord, like Hitler, like Gaddafi, and many more. When after the majority prove that there are no the right from wrong, it is always on small group of smart, enlightened people to change this world for the better. The majority of white folks were not right in the time of slavery. And all stupid irrational rules up the support bigotry. Sorry, princesses and princes, that I don't respect your self-entitled delusional mindset that you can own stuff, that you can own land, that you can own people, that you can own animals. That mindset is to me as insane as that the world is flat. Or that you can fly. Or that people are the most wise species on the planet. That's the reason we call ourselves Homo sapiens, which means wise in Latin. What a sick, ridiculous puppets we are. Dancing, effing, not caring about the world, not knowing we are nothing. We are not what was intended. So stop using that self-deluded appeal to authority logical fallacy. I just say, I hope you like my ranting of today. And I see you later. When darkness and light become one, the reality splinter away and the truth become visible.